Hello, Nikolai Markovich from Echo Lake Technologies, echolaketech.com. In this video, I'm going to show you another peer-to-peer free video chat and how to set it up in your Bubble app. And it's using this service called Hello 3.0. And their website is it's hello.co. And this is actually the product hunt page that I have here, because when you click on their link, it opens up a window and brings you right into their page. Hello. And so let's walk and go through this implementation in your Bubble app. So basically, it's pretty straightforward. I have a group here that I call Video Chat, type user, nothing fancy about the group. So basically, you know, come over here, get your group, drop it on the screen, and I made it, let's see, what is the dimensions of this? I made it a little bit bigger than the HTML that's inside of it, the HTML, let's see, right here. It's 500 and 400 for the HTML and 500 and 422, but you can, of course, set it up to whatever size you want. So what we have here is within the group, I put this HTML, and basically I copied this iframe width and the source and so forth, actually from a Groovio video that I had created. So this is largely the same from that video. And basically it's just, again, setting the size and width of the frame. And then basically what we have here is the source. So it's basically going to itshello.co. And what I've done here is it's current user's Groovio code. So again, I use some of the data structure from when I did the Groovio demo. And basically what this is going to have a unique ID. Now, itshello.co, if you went right to their site, it's going to randomly generate a key or code for you. But what we want to be able to do is assign our own code. So this way, when you're chatting with somebody else, you can tell them exactly which code to use. And then that way, you can control who has access to the codes. Now here, where it says allow video chat using Hello 3.0, enable video. So what I did here is I set up, let me go and click on, so this is my page, video chat using Hello. So I'm just clicking on that, and I'm clicking on the I here. And what I did was I created a custom state called enable video. It's of type text, and I have the default value of microphone and camera. So if you're not familiar with custom states, they're pretty neat. I'm just gonna go and create one real quick here. I do have some other videos on how to do custom states. I'll link that into this video if you're interested. So basically, I have this custom state here. And the reason why I have it, to go back to the HTML here, the reason why I have it is because to disable the video, and you'll see in the demo in a moment that the video just automatically comes up and it's ready to start a video. But you may want to, you know, disable that. So I have video enabled and video disabled over here, which I'll get to in a moment. And I use this custom state to control that. So video chat using Hello 3.0, which is the name of this page, and then enable video, which is the name of the custom state. And it's pretty straightforward. That's all, nothing fancy, no conditional or anything on this. Down below here, basically to enter the unique video code, it's of type text, so you just input whatever code that you want to put in here, and then you'll see that it will go and become current user's Groovio code when you click the submit code button here. Let's quickly get to that. It's real simple. So when they click on it, make changes to user, current user, the Groovio code is that input's value. I have, again, I'm reusing some data structure from when I did the Groovio demo, so that's why it says Groovio code here instead of Hello 3.0. So that's basically how we go and get this code to the user, and then we use it within the link from It's Hello. Okay, next thing we want to do is if we are in the middle of a chat with somebody or finishing up a chat with somebody and we want to stop it, we want a button to be able to do that. And basically all we do, it's real simple, it's the same current user, and then we assign a value of nothing. So the Groovio code is blank, it's empty. And then that way that will stop the video. Now, I'll show you in the demo when we do that. The hello will go and randomly assign a code in there. So the net effect of it all is that the video chat will end. Next thing I did was I added this toggle in here, and I have the preset value of checked, and you could choose whatever ones, but on this one I wanted it so when the page loads, it's checked, it's on. And basically nothing else that I did with this, so no conditionals, it's just pretty much right. Let's see, where is it? Ionic toggle right here. So that's all I did, just went and I grabbed that. That's the default values, nothing too fancy here, and just a simple text field. Okay, so the workflow for this toggle, so there's actually two of them, and you need two of them. One of them is for when it's checked, and then one of them when it isn't checked. Okay, so this first one, when it's checked, and that's when page loads, it's going to be checked. What we want to do is we want to assign the custom state, video chat, using hello, which if you scroll down here, where is it? I guess it's at the top of the page in this screen. In some pull-downs, the video chat, the page name, is you have to scroll down to the bottom to get to it. But in the set state, it's at the top here. And then enable a video, that's the name of my custom state. And then microphone and camera. So what this is going to do, I'm just going to jump back over here for a second into the HTML. It's going to assign enable video with microphone and camera. And what that's going to do is that's going to enable your devices, your phone, your laptop, whatever. It's going to enable the microphone and camera to work, which is what you want. And then basically I just reset data within that, within the group. So the reason why we have this group here and the HTML inside of the group, you can see from the data structure, so the HTML is a child to the group. The reason why we do that is because when you do a reset in video chat, it's going to reset the group, which in turn resets the HTML. It's kind of like if you did a page refresh, but within a group. The reason why we want to do that is because we're changing this value, this HTML value, when we toggle these switches to blank, which I'll show you in a moment, to microphone and camera. So we need to do this reset or else nothing is going to happen to that HTML page. Similarly, if the toggle is not checked, what we want to do is we want to put in a value of blank, and it's these parentheses here. So all you have to do, just type in the parentheses and that'll give it a blank. You actually can't leave it blank here or else it's actually not going to work. You have to put in these parentheses. So that's an important side note. And then reset that group. So this is an important thing to reset that group or else it's not going to behave as expected. These other slide bars, this is just for the menus that I had. I have a template. I just copied and paste pages. So these are just left over. So these are really the four workflow steps, making a change to the user, signing the code, and then here, blanking the code out, and then the toggle switch. So that's basically it for setting it up. Pretty straightforward. Now let's go and try this out. I'm going to do a page refresh here. So this is how the page is going to come up. And you can see here, because I have this user logged in, their value is 1111. Now, let me just go in the database here for the user, app data. Let me slow down here and just so that you're aware. So I went to all users, and these are the actual users. I just kind of made some of these up. And if you click on the little pencil here, it actually brings up the data for that user. Okay. Now Groovio code, it's the same code I used for the video. It's got it as 111. I'll just change it to 222. I save it. And then if I go back to this page, it's now 222. And if I go over here and I type 333, it is now going to be 333, just like that. All right, now I have another window open over here. And you can see, I have to do a page refresh on this. You can see that this is actually incognito window that I have in Chrome here. So every time I do a page refresh, its hello reassigns a different value. So 7P1BJ2, do a refresh, and so forth. Okay, but now I'm just going to come over here because I don't remember what I put, 333. If I type in 333 and hit submit code, there we go. Now we're going to get some feedback because I'm on both screens here. So you can imagine user 1 and user 2. So I'm going to stop the video chat like that. All right, so now you can see it's got this weird default value. I come back over here. Now this one is still in the video. So if I come back over here and just hit 333 again, it's going to go right back to where we were. But I'm going to stop that. And I'm going to stop this here as well. Okay. Let's see. Now, actually, something kind of funky happened here. I'll have to take a look at that. There we go. It's trying to reload. I think the video is trying to bring my computer to a halt here a little bit. But in any event, okay, so right now what I'm going to do is show you the video enabled and disabled. So again, the default video enabled, video disabled, and I get this pop-up that says site will not work without camera and microphone access. Yes, but if I go and click that back on, there we go, and I'll just type in submit code, just like that, and if I come back over here, and there it is. So that's, let me stop that. That is basically how we go and set up using Hello in our apps to do a free peer-to-peer video chat. So try it out, and I think you'll find it's a pretty nice little feature to add to your app. It's pretty straightforward, again, to go in and set this up. You can customize it however you want. I just added a couple of these little simple buttons on here to give you some control over it. The video code, again, you can enter it in. You can create a random number generator for it. And you can have the workflow. So if you wanted to talk to another user, you could actually have the workflow go and email them the code or text them a code or whatever you want to do with it so that they have the code. And if you could even set it up, depending on how your app is, that it will automatically go and install or add the code to them, and it'll automatically start the video with them. So again, yeah, try it out. If you have any comments or questions, please leave them below. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. I greatly appreciate it, and I will see you in the next video.